Hey, thought I'd make another video because I want to explain how my ME works. And that's not always rhyme or reason, so it's hard for me to explain it to people when I can't really explain everything to myself. Say I'm invited to go somewhere. Then at least four days ahead of time, I rest up even if I'm feeling good. I rest up so that I can be prepared for the outing. So that's why a lot of times it's better for me, especially if it's going to be like a motorcycle ride or an all-day outing that I know ahead of time so that I can prepare. Now, what is a good day for me? I have been having three pretty good days in a row. I haven't felt great. I never feel great. A good day is when I'm able to do things in my 15 to 20 minute segments and then rest. But lately, I think I've had too much caffeine, which isn't good, but yet at the same time, it's helped me get a lot done because it's making my legs have restless leg, that and Benadryl, and so I'm not able to rest as much as I should or would normally rest. So I've been getting a lot of stuff done. Why don't I do that normally? Well, it doesn't always work that way. I don't know what's going on now. I've been giving myself the B12 injections, and mostly I give them weekly. I've been trying to only do it monthly, but some weeks it really is helping that I've noticed. I need to cut back on my caffeine, because right now I'm feeling jittery inside, but I'm not feeling energetic. So that's a good day. But a good day for a person who isn't sick, I remember I used to wake up with energy and be bouncing off the walls. And then if you exercise, endorphins kick in. Well, I'm never bouncing off the walls, and the endorphins never kick in, even if I pushed myself, but I would crash from trying to get the endorphins kick in. Say I got on the stair stepper and I did as long as I could. The endorphins don't kick in, but I, bam, hit a wall and have all the fever and all the flu symptoms. Yeah. But I had to go to the dollar store to get a poster board and stuff for my 11-year-old. And at the dollar store, I almost fell over. I didn't trip or anything. I just got dizzy and almost fell over. So, yeah. That's the best I can explain. And sometimes the last minute stuff will work. But that's only if it's last minute for me, usually. Because I never know when I'm going to feel good enough. So, when I feel good enough, it's like, hurry, act on it. My bra straps always show, guys. But hurry, act on it before it passes. And of course, nobody can do anything at that time when that happens, of course. I mean, and I'm not mad at anybody for that, because how could I be? But a lot of times, if someone else invites me at the last minute, I'm not filling up to it. Every once in a while, a miracle might happen and planets align and whoa, I'm able to go. But usually I have to know ahead of time and then prepare and then let everybody know, because I don't know when I'm going to have my 11-year-old, except for during the week I usually have her. But her dad takes her every chance that he gets. He lives close by, so it works out good for us. So that's part of the reason I need to know ahead of time. Also, I mentioned that I'm doing the B12 injections, right? Okay, I started doing the B12 injections at home instead of at the doctor's, because it's a pain to go to the doctor's, and because I always fall asleep at the doctor's office too. So it's just easier to do it at home, and then the doctor's office will only do it once a month. So, and I swear sometimes it helps to do it once a week or every other week or whatever. And I get those from B12Shot.com. Sorry, I mentioned everything. And then Allegro Medical.com is where I get the needles to do those injections. You gotta make sure you get the intramuscular needles. I've had too much caffeine. That's why it's like restless leg all over, but without the energy part. was something else I was going to say, and I can't think of it. Okay, well, hopefully that clarifies some stuff about what is a good day. A really bad day is I'm in bed all day. You know, I'll get up. I'm able to take care of myself on the bad days, but I'll get up, and when my daughter goes to school, then I go back to bed. That's a really, really bad day. A typical day is for me to rest do things in segments of 15, 20 minutes, and then rest, and then do some more stuff, and then rest. And I can't say how long my rest start matters on how I'm doing that day. And I may go from my bed to the couch and stuff. I may watch TV, or I may read in bed, or I may actually sleep. And sometimes if I'm laying in bed, I'm not even sleeping. I'm just laying there just to rest. Not doing anything, just resting. All right, guys. I will talk to you later.